So here's a stereo patch with two oscillators going into low pass gates, and those are panned left and right onto those inputs for the owl. But first you select a patch by holding down the LED button. It will then flash and the A knob becomes a bank select, and the B knob a patch select. So this is bank A, patch 1. The first patch is a JOT reverb or JOT reverb, here's that dry and wet. We've then got room size, pre-delay, and cutoff for dampening. Taking that out, here's another reverb, and we're going to patch select and patch 2 in bank A. This is the freeverb patch, and we've got dry wet, room size, and dampening. This is bank A and patch 8, which is a phaser. We've got the rate, the depth and feedback, and then a nice wet juicy phaser on those drums from the radio music module. Let's look at some delays, and this is bank B, patch 1. This is a stereo delay, but we've just got a single input. We've got the dry wet control on knob D. Delay time on A. Feedback on B. An input level on C. And you can really mangle the sound with some random unsynced CV into the delay time. So that's getting pretty mangled, let's add some CV to the feedback as well. So it's great for sample fodder and mangled messed up sound design, but you also get a really nice clean digital delay as well. Going into patch B3, we've got a low pass delay, and we've got mix, delay time, and cutoff. We can take an LFO to control C to modulate the filter's cutoff. Using a vocal sample from the radio music module, here's the pitch shifter effect on patch B4, with a dry wet control on D.
No, ya vamos a hablar, ya lo estoy esperando.
Pitch shift on A. Then window size. And we can get instant minion sounds. You can pitch this down below 12 on the knob. And you get almost ring mod and downsampled style sounds too. Moving into bank C, these are Ollie Larkin's patches, and the first patch is a drone box. I've already got a string pluck playing into the module, and here it's fully dry. Here's going fully wet on the drone box. We've got coarse tuning. And fine tune. And then the decay of those ringing strings in the drone box. Here's dry again, and then wet. And with an LFO into the fine tune, we can get a nice, soft, warm, moving pad-like sound. By changing the input sound, we can get a more plucked string-type response. Here's a drum sound going in. So that's an 808 style kick. Let's turn that fully wet. Sticking with the kick drum, the next patch is C2, which is called a blipper, which is a synth laser or zap style sound generator. And here's the dry wet. We control the bass pitch on A. And the amount of pitch modulation on B. And the release from the envelope follower following the input on C. Going to bank C patch 3, we've got what's called a weird phaser. We'll get rate control, a rate scale, a left and right offset, and then feedback control. Let's change this input to something that's just simple and droning. Patch C4 is a through zero flanger, and this is a simple plain saw wave into both inputs. Working right to left, we've got depth, left and right offset, which is nice for widening up this in stereo, the delay amount, and the rate. Take an LFO into the CV for A to modulate the rate, and another LFO into C to modulate the left and right offset. And here's a sweep of that oscillator's pitch. So there's lots of stereo spread and rich modulation. Patch C5 is a dual pitch shifter. I'll take the CV out and here's the mix amount. We can shift the left amount on A and the right amount on B. And C controls the window size. Patch C8 is Ollie Larkin's XFM oscillator patch, and I've got the outputs into a low pass gate which I'll turn up. Oscillator 1's pitch is on A, and 2 on B. Got feedback for oscillator 1 on C, and feedback for oscillator 2 on D. CV all the parameters like you can in the other patches. If I strike the low pass gate I'm using, this FM drone box makes for a great percussion synthesis source. This is bank D, and we start with a basic EQ tone control with a treble on C, the mid on B, and the bass on A. These work great with LFOs to create phaser style sounds, is another LFO into C. And with that bit of sick wave drone in, let's go into bank D and patch 2. And this is a Big Muff style fuzz with the output control, input level, drive, and tone. Let's take a triangle wave as our input instead of a saw wave. And you can hear the fuzz really opens up when we start to push that input level. Using drums as our input, here's a compressor, and you've just got to be a little bit careful with that makeup gain when you're playing around with a compressor. Control D is the makeup gain. We've got ratio on A, threshold on B, which is already down, and various attack times on C. Sticking with drum sounds, we've got a flanger patch on D8. This is the dry wet, and then feedback. We've got frequency control on A, and depth control on B. Patch E1 is the MK Complexo, which is an audio mangler. Here's the dry wet, an input level, the iterations, and the chaos on C. Going to patch E2, this is a multiband distortion with gain on D, distortion for the high frequencies on C, which gives a nice crunchy top, mid distortion on B, and low frequency distortions on A. Going into patch E, this is a digital mayhem patch with sampling frequency, mayhem rate, mayhem frequency, and the depth on D. It's a really fun audio mangler. Patch E4 is a siren generator, and we've got gain, the tuning, and the mode. So if we go to hoxtonowl.com, you can see the forum and the community pages and all the documentation and downloads that you might need. We've got the Owl Control software, which can control the Owl and exchange patches and firmware. The USB controls the updates for the Owl, and these are instant, and you can control patches with the knobs on screen to instantly change what's happening on the module, or control knobs on the module to change what's happening on screen as well, and this is all instant. There's input sensitivity if you're getting any clipping from, say, the compressor's makeup gain or some of the gain boosts on those EQs. Here's a few screenshots going around the screen to show you all of these things. And using a DAW, you can actually send MIDI program changes to change these patches on the fly if you're integrating a computer into your setup. Let's load in a user patch, and we're going to go with one from 4MS, who are also makers of many fine modules, and I've downloaded the patch from the website. Using the Owl Control software, I can open up the SysX file and load that into the Owl. With the patch playing, this is the arpeggiator from 4MS, and we can control the arp speed, the arp type on B, the delay time on C, and the delay feedback on D. So that's a nice little fun patch from 4MS. So there's so much potential from that OWL module, and it's too much for me to get through in one video, so I've just cherry-picked a few patches. There's also lots of potential for development in the future, as essentially it's just running code, and there's a compiler to run pure data patches as well that you can run on the device. So on that note, I will follow this video up with a future video looking at some more patches, as we've got some more user patches coming from Ollie Larkin and others in the future as well. As always, hit like and subscribe for more videos every week, and check the Patreon link in the description if you'd like to support my channel.